Hello students, today we are going to learn a new chapter, that is states of matter. Apart from plasma state, we have solid, liquid, gas. In this chapter we will be more focused on gaseous state. You will learn this solid state and liquid state in class 12. Most of the characteristics of chemical system that we see are bulk properties, that is they are associated with collection of large number of atoms, ions and molecules. For example, a single molecules of liquid cannot boil off its own, it's bulk that bonds. The physical state is also a bulk property of water. Similarly, a single molecule of water cannot wet on its own, but the collection of water molecules that have the wetting property. The physical state is also a bulk property. Water can exist as solid, liquid or in gaseous state or in vapor state. The chemical composition of water in all the three states is same. Such states contain the same H2O molecules. The characteristics of water in all the three states depends upon the energy of the molecule and also the arrangement of the molecules. So with this, the change in physical state, the chemical property does not change. Let us understand more about this physical states of matter, but for that we have to understand first the intermolecular forces. The intermolecular forces are the forces of attraction or repulsion between the interacting species. Suppose we have hydrogen fluoride, so it will interact with the another molecule of hydrogen fluoride. So this is nothing but it is the intermolecular interaction. So students, for example, we can take ethanol, boils at lower temperature than water just because of this intermolecular force of attraction interaction. Water tends to spread out on the surface more than the mercury owing to the intermolecular forces. So intermolecular force of attraction, it is a polar interaction and non-polar interaction. Here in this, charges are involved. Here charges are not involved. Okay, now this polar interaction will show by polar molecules. So polar molecules that occur when the atom do not share the electron equally. For example, we have H2O, we have HF, we have HCl, etc. For non-polar molecules, the interaction will be shown by non-polar molecules. It will be H2, O2, N2 and helium, neon, argon, krypton, etc. So this all molecule will be shown shows the non-polar interaction. So first of all, in polar interaction we have dipole interaction, second we have dipole induced dipole interaction, dipolar interaction, and third one is ion induced dipole interaction, polar interaction. Here we have London forces, or we can say dispersion force. The covalent bond in which participating atom differ in the electronegative value are of polar nature. So we have HF, which is bonded with one another molecule of HF. It will acquire a positive, partial positive charge, and this will acquire a partial negative charge. So this interaction is dipole interaction. This happens because this atom differ in the electronegative value. Suppose it has got 2.1 the electronegative value and it has got 4 the electronegative. The difference in the electronegative value creates what the partial positive and partial negative charge, and this partial negative and positive charge is given by that is delta. So first they develop a permanent dipole moment, permanent dipole moment, and second slight delta positive and delta negative charge is developed on H and F, which is less than the unit charge, that is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. So the third point is the interaction energy is inversely proportional to r to the power 6, where r is the distance between the polar molecule. So r is the distance between the polar molecule. So as I told, they develop a positive and negative charge, and so they have already a permanent dipole is there, so positive and negative, and there is attraction, or that interaction is known as intermolecular force of attraction, and that is dipole and dipole interaction. Our next is dipole induced dipolar interaction. Here we take an example of carbon tetrachloride, which is symmetrical in nature and this is non-polar, and it will develop slight positive charge and negative charge because of difference in electronegative. When it comes in close contact with acetone, that is CH3CO CH3, so here we have positive, again here negative, so there will be a electron cloud will be developed. Since this is a non-polar in nature, so it will develop a negative charge, electron cloud will be developed, and there will be a attraction or an interaction between the positive and the negative CCl4 and acetone. This is acetone and this is CCl4, carbon tetrachloride. So similarly, we can see about water, H2O. So this is polar in nature. Okay, this will positive, this is positive. When it interacts with a noble gas, that is monoatomic atom, that is xenon, so it will also, a charge will be induced between this. So this is positive and this is negative. So there is a charge, that charge will be induced between them. So that is dipole induced dipole interaction. Or next is ion dipole interaction. Okay, now here in ion we know that it is cation and it is anion. Okay, this cation and anion will interact with a polar molecule. Now when we place when we dissolve NaCl in water, so what happens? This will break to cation and anion. Now this cation is surrounded by the water molecule. See, in this way. So the cation is smaller. Here the interaction is in this way, whereas for anion that is large, the size is large. Now the interaction will be like this. So this is H plus, this is H plus, again plus. So in the in this type of interaction is known as, that is ion dipole interaction. The ion is attracted towards the oppositely charged end of the dipole molecule, and the strength depends upon the size and the charge. Since the charge both are having what, Na positive and Cl negative, but the size differs. The size is smaller for cation and bigger for anion. So and also the dipole moment of the this ions. So this is ion dipole interaction. Our next interaction is London force of interaction, that is London force, or we can say dispersion force. So this occur in nonpolar molecule, as I said earlier. Now nonpolar molecule, and that are H2, Cl2, N2, and in addition to that, the noble gas element, that is helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, this all will be, they will all show this London dispersion force. Now, we know these are all monoatomic gases. Now, the interaction, if you take an example of helium, we know helium, its atomic number is 2 and mass number is 4. So we have a helium atom with the nucleus, in the nuclear charge with 2 positive charge and 2 electrons in its orbit, which is symmetrical, and it coincides in this way. Okay, this is atom A. This is an atom A. At an instance, what happens is this electron starts moving randomly because it is not stationary. And an instance will come when this electron will shift to one end of the this orbit. So it will distort in this way. So this will be what, this will be instantaneous instantaneous dipolar. Okay, now what is this? Now this is atom A. Now this atom A, again when it comes in contact with B, atom B, atom B, this is atom B, this is instantaneous dipolar atom A. So a moment will come, instant will come at point of time, this will be attracted, this will induce, the charge will be induced to this atom B, and thereby this also will be distort, this shape also will be get distort, and it will be like this, that is the positive charge will come to this end on the left hand side, and here again a negative charge. So this is atom A and this is atom B. So this type of weak, this is nothing but it is London force or dispersion force, weak interaction, London force of interaction, or I can say it is dispersion force. So as I told, this is a weak force of interaction. So force of attraction are generally weak, and the magnitude that depends upon the surface area in contact or the molecular size. The greater the molecular size, more will be the force of attraction there as compared in terms of boiling point. So we can take an example, for example isomeric pentane, that is C5H12, the longest chain, that is the straight chain isomer, have higher boiling point compared to the branch chain isomer. So we can take an example, for example C5H12, so this is n-pentane, it will have a boiling point of 309 Kelvin. Now the other is 2-methyl butane, it will have a boiling point as 310 K, and the isomeric, again the other isomeric pentane, that is (2,2-dimethylpropane), it will have a boiling point of 283 Kelvin. So what we see, the longest chain, that is the molecular size, it will take a more surface area, so it has what, 309, although this is a London force of attraction, and here the surface area is bit small compared to this, so 301 K, whereas here the molecular size, again it shortens, so the boiling point is 283 K. So in this way we can explain that is London force of attraction by comparing the boiling point. Okay, the another case of interaction is the dipole-dipole interaction, that is of hydrogen bonding, but that doesn't come under this category. So this all are known as, this all forces are combined, this all combined forces are known as weak van der Waals forces. Okay, now in the last class, in the last chapter, you have read about the hydrogen bonding. In this, the hydrogen bonding is linked by a high electronegative atom, that is, we can say fluorine, oxygen and nitrogen. So fluorine has got the electronegative value of, that is 4, and here the electronegative value is 3, and here the electronegative value is of nitrogen is 3. So hydrogen bonding will take place between HF, H2O and NH3. So these are all limited. These are also, this is also a dipole-dipole interaction. Okay, students. So students, next is our thermal energy. In solid, it is least; in liquid, moderate; and gas, there is, it is large. Whereas in intermolecular interaction, the gases, it is least; liquid, it is moderate; and solid, it is high. So next, our next topic is the measurable property of gases. First is mass of gas. For numerical, we need this, that is mass of gas. If how it has been calculated, suppose a empty cylinder is there, we will take the mass of that cylinder, okay, and when the it has been filled with some gas, suppose say W1, when it is filled with gas, it is W2, so difference of W2 minus W1. So we know that mass of gas is generally expressed in terms of moles. So number of moles is equal to mass of the gas divided by molar mass. So generally we will be expressing this in grams. Okay, so we know that is 1 kg is equal to 10 to the power 3 gram. So as the molar mass is gram per mole, so we will be expressing maximum in our numerical in grams only. Okay, so next property is volume of gas. So volume of gas is same as that of the container, as you all know, and it is usually expressed in liter. So one, as I know, as you know, 1 meter cube is equal to 1 decimeter cube or 10 to the power 6 centimeter cube. So 1 ml is equal to 1 cc, or we can say 1 centimeter cube, or 1 liter is equal to 1000 ml, or 1 decimeter cube, or 10 to the power 3 centimeter cube. So these are all the units that will be there in the numericals, and we have to calculate according to this. Suppose if in a container, there is a solid in this, okay, and how to calculate the volume of the gas means this is X and the whole container is V. So we will take what volume of gas is V minus X. Okay, next is our pressure of gas. So gas, so in a container, if there is a gas, okay, it will strike on the walls of the container or vessel in which it has been taken. Okay, now as you know, this is nothing but it is a force, or force that the gas collides with on the wall of the container. So we know pressure is equal to force by area. So force is given by Newton per meter square. So Newton meter square, which is nothing but it is a Pascal, 1 Pascal. So another way to another unit is 1 atm is equal to 76 centimeter of Hg, or 760 mm of Hg, or 760 torr Okay. Now, then 1 bar. It can also express in 1 bar. It is 10 to the power 5 Pascal. And that is 1 bar is equal to 0.987 atm. Okay, and one more is there, that is 1 atm is equal to 101325 Pascal, or you can say 101.325 kilo Pascal. So these are all the units that will come in the numerical. So next is our temperature of the gas, which is usually expressed in Kelvin, that is 2 centigrade plus 273. Okay.